I've listed and sold hundreds of for sale by owners in my career. In fact, I've taught thousands and thousands of real estate agents my exact for sale by owner conversion system. And I've also, over the past 7 or 8 years, I've uploaded over 150 training videos on how to convert for sale by owners right here on the YouTube channel. And so what I've done in this video is I've taken some of those videos that I've uploaded and I've combined those to generate this free masterclass where I'm literally going to walk you through in this video, step by step, exactly how to convert a for sale by owner into a listing. Now, I'm going to break down how this the structure of this video is going to work in a second. But have I made updates to the system over the years? Of course. So you're going to see me make live cold calls. You're going to hear scripts. You're going to hear strategies, tactics, techniques, et cetera. That, yes, I probably, if I'm coaching an agent today, I probably have made some updates. So I don't want you to look at this and say, well, wait a minute, Brandon. In this video, you said to do X, Y, and Z. And I watched another video and you said to do something different. I've made hundreds of thousands of dollars of commissions doing exactly what I'm going to show you in this video. There have been thousands of agents who have executed on the tactics and strategies you're going to learn in this video. So let me show you exactly what we're going to cover in this masterclass. In chapter one, I'm going to walk you through the entire for sale by owner conversion strategy. I'm going to go through the entire conversion funnel. In chapter two, I'll walk you through the tactics and the techniques that you can use and implement so that you can beat out other agents that you might be competing with to win for sale by owner listings. In chapter three, I'll walk you through a for sale by owner script that you can use to start setting listing appointments. Yes, we talk a lot about preview appointments in this masterclass, but in chapter three, I specifically teach you how to set listing appointments with for sale by owners. In chapter four, I'm going to teach you, or you're going to hear me rather, make live for sale by owner calls to real prospects. I'll set real appointments. I'll respond to real objections. You'll hear me on the phone. These are calls that I made over the past, I don't know, 4 or 5 years. You'll get to hear those live. Chapter five, I'm going to walk you through the entire for sale by owner follow-up system. Step by step by step. In chapter six, I'm gonna walk you through what to do at a FSBO preview appointment, step by step. And then in chapter seven, I'll walk you through, or you'll be able to hear rather, me making live for sale by owner follow-up calls with people in the pipeline that I've converted from follow-up into a listing appointment set. So here's the deal. First off, why for sale by owners as a niche? Well, for me, there's really two things. Number one, they would constitute as what we would call a hand raiser. In other words, if we look at the business of real estate sales, it's the reason why it's so difficult, unlike other sales businesses, is people don't move that often, right? They're only moving a couple of times their entire year. And this is why relying on just your sphere of influence, it's just not enough. It's not enough. So that's number one. Number two, this is why I love them so much. It's the easiest, I'm telling you, it's the easiest lead to contact. So if you look at all different lead sources, whether you're buying leads, whether you're door knocking, whether you're cold calling, whether you're, doesn't matter what your model is, a for sale by owner is the easiest lead to contact. And yes, it's a seller opportunity. It's a listing opportunity, not a buying opportunity, although you could get a buyer out of it as well. These people are pinned to their phone waiting for the next phone call. Why? They're waiting for the buyer, the potential buyer for their property to potentially call them. And so they're glued to the phone the second they put their house up for sale, hoping and thinking that the next buyer is going to be contacting them. So that's why I love it as a niche. Now, you might be watching this and say, dude, I cannot, Brandon. I cannot go after these for sale by owners. It's too frustrating. I just don't have any real success with them. They're too hard to convert. I'm going to show you exactly what you can do in just a second that's going to change all of that for you. All right. So now let's talk about what I call the FSBO conversion funnel. So, and by the way, I'm not sure if this is for you or not. You can decide. But if you're a real estate agent, you're watching this video and you're not earning at least $100,000 per year, you feel like you're overworked, you're underpaid, maybe even underappreciated, perhaps it's time to talk. If you're serious about growing your real estate sales business and you're open to having a conversation to determine if working with me as your coach makes sense or not, then click the link in the description beneath this video or simply go to reverseselling.com to book a call. These are the numbers. All right. So this is what I want you to pay really, really close attention to. So here's the model. All right. So this is exactly what I taught Mark. This is exactly what I did in my real estate sales business. So number one, in most markets across the country, you are probably getting about 3 for sale by owners per day. Now, where you can find those, you can get those from Zillow, you can get them from Craigslist, you can get them from Vulcan 7, which is what I use. There's a link in the description to check them out. You can get them a lot of different places, but in every market across the country, you are probably getting on average about 3 for sale by owners a day that come into the marketplace, which is about 90 per month. So that's our total opportunity. So of that opportunity, we say, okay, how many can we actually contact? Well, through tracking this, as long as I have, you should be able to contact about 50%. In this case, that's 45 FSBOs. And we're contacting them either through calling them, door knocking, or FSBO open houses. So those are really the 3 main ways. Yes, you can probably text them. Yes, you could probably message them on Facebook or Instagram. But mainly, we're going to call them, we're going to door knock them, or we're going to see them at their for sale by owner open house. All right. So we talked to about 45 of them. That's our 50% contact rate. Well, what ends up happening? Once we've made contact, and I'm going to walk you through the strategy in just a second, we should be able to generate a lead, and I'll explain to you what that is in just a second, about 35% of the time. So if we look at this, right, and we say, okay, if I'm going to make contact with 45 of them, and I have a 35% conversion into an actual lead, that's about 16 FSBO leads that we're going to put into the pipeline that will convert into listings, which you're going to see how that happens in just a minute. All right. So let me just talk about what is a lead. Well, a lead in our book, when I'm coaching a real estate agent, is a for sale by owner that either A, you set a preview appointment and you went to go visit them face to face, and or B, which I'll talk more about preview appointments in just a minute and what they are and what they are not. A real definition of a lead when we're talking about for sale by owners is we ask them one qualifying question. And this is the script. So you're either asking the for sale by owner when you visit them in person at a preview appointment, or you knocked on their door, or you saw them at an open house, or over the telephone, and you ask the for sale by owner, listen, Mr. For Sale by Owner, if in a couple of weeks, for whatever reason, you're unsuccessful selling the home on your own, which I don't know if it will be the case for you or not, but if that happens, then at that point, would you be totally opposed to meeting with me and giving me the opportunity to help you get the property on the market and get it sold? That's what we constitute is as a lead. So when we say, what is a lead when it comes to for sale by owners? You should be able to get 35%. And for a lot of our agents that I coach, they're getting a lot higher conversion, but on average, you should be able to get 35% of the for sale by owners that you talk to say, yeah, listen, if we can't sell it on our own, sure, we'd be open to looking at other options. Sure, we'd be open to meeting with you and interviewing you to help us get this property sold. That's what we constitute as a lead, just so that we're on the same page. So now we have these 16 leads, right? Now what happens next is based on what I'm gonna show you, we put those 16 people into our pipeline and we follow up, and we're able to convert, usually on average, 50% into an actual listing appointment. So in this case, it's about 8. This happens over a 6 to 8 week period of follow-up, which we'll talk about in just a minute. And then lastly, you should be able to, based on having a compelling listing presentation, you should be able to convert 50% of those into actual listings. And in this case, this is 4. So the way the pipeline or this funnel actually works is, let's just say you started this in January. Let me show you what happens. February and March. And in January, I'll show you how this looks. In January, Remember, we said you should be able to generate 16 leads in January. Well, those leads in February, you should be able to do the same thing, generate another 16 leads. So now in your pipeline, you've got about 30 FSBO leads in total. And of these, because that's about 8 weeks or 2 months, this is where you should have 3 to 4 listings in the ground. And the same thing happens the next month, and the same thing happens the next month, and the same thing happens the next month if you do what I'm going to show you right now. So here is the entire secret on how to list for sale by owners. All right. So here's how this works. The first time I showed this to Mark, he conceptualized it and said, yes, this makes sense. But once he converted his first for sale by owner based on this model I'm going to show you, it became a lot easier for him to duplicate those results and allowed him to get one FSBO listing every single week. You will be able to do the exact same thing. All right. So here's a graph. On the left hand side of this graph is the percentage, we'll call it likelihood the FSBO will list. And so at the bottom, we have 0% likelihood. At the top is 100% likelihood. All right. On the bottom, we have time. So we have week one, we'll go week one, week two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. Right. So here's literally how this entire thing works. So a for sale by owner comes into the marketplace on its first day. And as you know, you guys are probably part of this, of course, they just get destroyed with calls from for sale by owners. I mean, they just get absolutely hammered, right? And all of these agents are being good agents. They're doing exactly what they've been taught to do, which is to call the for sale by owner and try to convince that for sale by owner to list it with them, right? I mean, that's what they're doing. And the question is, if a for sale by owner, which we already know to be the case, has a worldview that they don't want to work with a real estate agent, that they're going to try and sell this on their own, and remove the word try, actually, they're just going to sell this thing on their own, because when they hit the market for the first day, their optimism is also at an all-time high. So what is the likelihood? Because I can already hear it in the comments. Well, I can convert that. I'm just saying, what is the likelihood that a for sale by owner on the first day they put their house up on the market that they're going to list with a real estate agent? It's very, very low. It's extremely low. But you still have all these real estate agents in the marketplace just calling them, door knocking them, messaging them. And this for sale by owner starts to get really, really frustrated. No, I'm good. I'm good. I'm good. No, I'm not listing it. I'm not listing it. All these agents are trying everything, every script they know, every tactic they know to try to convince them why they should list it with them. And this goes on for quite a while, right? Because what ends up happening is over time, the likelihood that these for sale by owners are going to list it with a real estate agent, it goes up over time. As their optimism goes down because they still haven't sold it, week over week over week over week over week over week over week, they say, wow, maybe we can't do this. Maybe we do need to start considering talking to a real estate agent. And here's the secret. In week two, you still have a lot of people calling, but not nearly as much. In week three, you still have people calling, not nearly as much. And this goes on week after week after week until what ends up happening, because all conversion, my friends, all conversion with for sale by owners, on average, is usually happens with inside weeks 6 through 8. This is when all conversion happens. But the thing is this, here's what all these agents are missing, is all these agents that are calling in weeks 1, 2, 3, they're all playing the short game. They're all playing instant gratification. They have a binary thinking to say, I'm going to call this for sale by owner and I'm going to try like heck to do my thing and to convince them to list it with me. And most of them fail, right? Because of what we just talked about. And then it's off to the next one. They forget about it. They don't have a system for following up. They don't have a system of conversion. So here's the deal. What a smart agent will do, and this is what I would coach an agent to do, is listen, when you call this person on the first day they hit the market, this is you being the smart agent, this is Mark, this is me, on the first day, we're going to do a complete 180 versus what every other agent's doing. We're going to do the exact opposite of what every other agent is doing. Well, what is that, you ask? This is us telling the for sale by owner that they should have no issues selling it on their own. Brandon, are you kidding me? Why would you say that? Why would you tell me to do that? Well, because the likelihood of them listing it with an agent on the first day of them hitting the market anyways is almost next to zero. What your competitors don't understand is they're losing the opportunity on the very first day this thing hits the market, but not you. You, my friend, being the smart agent as you are, you're playing the long game. And on the very first day, we're going to communicate the fact to say, listen, I don't care what all these other mules are saying. You can sell this on your own. And isn't that true? Don't a lot of for sale by owners sell on their own? And what you're going to do instead is you're going to set right here on that first conversation, you're going to set a preview appointment. While your competitors are trying to get them to list the property, you'll be the only agent in the market who is communicating the exact opposite. You're going to communicate to the seller, listen, you can sell this thing on your own. I don't care what all the other agents are saying. My question for you is this, go right back to the script. If you cannot sell over the next couple of weeks, then at that point, would you be completely against, would you be completely opposed to having a meeting with me to see what I can do to help you get the property sold, assuming I can net you the amount of money that you need in your pocket bottom line? Because let's face it, I mean, the only way you'd consider hiring me to sell your home is if I could put the money in your pocket that you needed. Am I right? And they say, a large percentage of them says that's exactly right. So then we follow that up by saying this, here's what a preview appointment is and here's what it is not. We never, and let me just say this one more time, we never set an appointment with a for sale by owner under the circumstances that they believe that you have a buyer. That is not what we're doing here. When I'm talking about a preview appointment here, after we've gone through the script I just outlined, the next thing we're going to say is, Mr. For Sale by Owner, then can I make a recommendation? To which the For Sale by Owner says, well, sure, what's up? If you want, why don't you invite me over one day this week? You can show me the home. And when I'm there, again, I know you're not ready to do anything right now. When I'm there, I'll walk you through my For Sale by Owner backup plan so you can see exactly what it looks like and how I can help you get the property sold in the event that you can't. And then you can decide if this is potentially an option you'd consider down the road or not. Is that something you'd be completely opposed to right now? And what you're going to find is either A, they say, no, that's fine, come on over. Or B, even if you don't get that appointment, you still generate the lead. Remember I talked about that earlier in the training? These leads that we talked about right here? That's what I'm talking about. You could still get your 16 leads per month that you need to put into the pipeline, regardless if you get the appointment here or not. But we're still going to ask for this appointment right now so that you can determine on the first day which of these are going to be a lead or not. Now, what's next? What you're going to do, once you have your, you've gone through that little strategy on the first day, and once you have now identified your 16 leads for the month, you're then going to put them in your pipeline, and here's what you're going to do. As the weeks go on, week after week after week, here's what you're going to do. Every week, you're going to call them on Monday. Let me do this. What you're going to do is you're going to email them every Wednesday. You're going to send them a piece of direct mail, which they should get every Thursday. And you should text them every Friday. You're going to do this over this entire period of time between the first time you talk to them all the way throughout to they get into the red zone. And remember, what is the red zone? This is where we see all the for sale by owners waving the white flag to say, yep, I give up. I cannot do this. So that the entire time you've been the one that has followed up consistently, you've been the one to support them throughout their journey of trying to sell on their own. You've been the one to support their autonomy in doing so. You've been the one to say, listen, do your thing. In the event you can't, then there's some other options for you that I can show you. And that entire time, as your competitors continue to berate the for sale by owner to try to pressure them into doing something they don't want to do, they're losing opportunities left and right. You're staying in the pocket week after week after week after week until they get into the red zone. And what ends up happening within 6 to 8 weeks after you've followed up, just like I've outlined, you find yourself on a consistent flow of listing opportunities. And so I want you to just think through this, right? I know this is only a 20-minute training, but if you can get out of the mindset to say, listen, I got to just get away from this instant gratification, this binary thinking, this all or nothing thinking, this black and white thinking, to say, if I don't close them on this one phone call, they're dead to me. Just get that out of your mind and say, listen, I have to build a pipeline of prospects that go into my database. At the bottom of the pipeline, just like any other pipeline, at the bottom of the pipeline through the process I just outlined to you, comes consistent listing appointments, comes consistent listing opportunities. Because I'm telling you what, your competitors won't do this. They will not play the long game. You might even be watching this video or listening to this on the podcast and saying, yeah, until this, I was one of those agents. I would call and try to do my thing. It not work because I don't have a follow-up system and I'd lose out all these opportunities. Heck, there's never been a time, Brandon, where I had a system where I was talking to first sell by owners 6, 7, 8 weeks into the future. And ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, that's when all the conversion takes place, at least 80% of it. Yes, you could get some FSBO listings sooner than that, but 80, 85, 90% of for sale by owners that end up listing with a real estate agent do so 6 to 8 weeks into the future. So if we know that ahead of the time, let's play chess, not checkers. Let's be a little bit more strategic in what we do and how we handle a for sale by owner throughout the life cycle of them hitting the market. And I promise you, you're going to find yourself listing 2, 3, 4 for sale by owners every single month. There's a bunch of tactical things that we're going to get into in today's episode. I want to start off by what I believe will help the audience the most, and then we'll work through some specific tactical things. And that is this. Unlike, I'm trying to think through all different lead sources. Unlike any other lead source, the mindset I think most real estate agents have, which is probably, Dominic, why I think some agents struggle with this lead source, is the likelihood for an agent to get a listing appointment or a listing with a for sale by owner right away is very, very, very unlikely. Very unlikely. And any agent that is used to outbound prospecting has a mindset of the exact opposite. They're in that their mindset, and it's not right, or it's not right or wrong, it's kind of what we coach to, is to look for the appointment now. So with a for sale by owner, that opportunity is just smaller than any other lead source. And as a result, it requires a different mindset. Let me explain, okay? I almost want to draw this out, but I'm not going to try to plug in technology and screw up the show that way. But here's what I want the audience to imagine, whether you're listening or you're watching this show. A for sale by owner hits the market, right? They show up on Zillow and you have every single real estate agent calling this person like they're supposed to do, like an expired listing. And most of them are trying to convert that person right now. They're approaching it from all different angles. They're saying all kinds of things. They're using all types of different scripts, but nonetheless, they're trying to convince the for sale by owner to do something right now that is different than what they've decided to do. And let me tell you why that's a huge mistake. The for sale by owner, on the day they enter the marketplace, their optimism of selling on their own is at its highest point. To call somebody during that period of time and try to get them to change their worldview in 5 minutes is virtually impossible. It's virtually impossible. It would be like calling a Democrat and trying to switch them to a Republican in one phone call. I mean, that's the likelihood that we're talking about. We're talking about a worldview. We're not talking about someone getting a Reese's thin versus the whole Reese's. That's the argument with my girls all the time. It's like, which one's better? We're not talking about that. We're talking about a worldview. And the worldview that the for sale by owner has the first day they hit the market is, I am going to sell this on my own. It's the real estate agents that have a mindset or an understanding of all these stats and I can do it better. And that's fine. That's fine. To make that argument to the for sale by owner on day one is like landing on deaf ears. So what ends up happening is these people end up losing the opportunity with these people right from the get-go because they end up in conflict with the for sale by owner. And after that initial conversation, it goes nowhere. Well, here's what ends up happening. So that's all the first day and the first week. Then the second week, you've got maybe half of those agents following up with the for sale by owner because the for sale by owner conversion game is all about the long game, right? And most conversion with for sale by owners happens and I've been tracking this for over a decade, between week 6 and week 8. That's where all conversion happens. However, we also know that there are very, 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 very few real estate agents that will be in the game 6 to 8 weeks later, because they have already ruined the opportunity up until this point, and they don't have the patience to wait it out, A. And then B, we're going to talk about another thing in just a second, which is to be their agent while they think they don't need one, so that when they end up wanting to hire one, you get the business automatically. So this is a game of understanding what I'm trying to explain, which is, this is a game of likelihoods. So rather than approaching the for sale by owner like you would an expired listing, like you would an absentee owner, like you would with a circle prospecting call, like you would with any other prospecting conversation, we're actually looking to do something a little bit different. And that is to speak in hypotheticals about the future. So let me give a tactical example. One of the things I always have fun with in our coaching calls with our clients is I give this example. It would be, I think this is, the audience will get a kick out of this. It would be like going up to somebody on their wedding day, Dominic, right? And after they've both said yes, they're on their way down the aisle. You stop them on the way back after everyone's cheering for them and say, hey, are you guys thinking about getting a divorce? It would be hysterical, right? Well, you probably get kicked out of the wedding. But I think you'd get more, I think you'd get further in that conversation if you were to use a skill that we often talk about with inside the reverse selling methodology, which is to not put people in a corner, but rather speak in hypotheticals. And what I mean by that is this. So if the person's coming down the aisle who just got married, and you said to one of the spouses to say, listen, if this guy ends up being a bonehead a couple years from now and does something really dumb, you know, he probably won't, right? He probably won't. He's a good dude. But if he just does something stupid, you know, would you be totally against finding somebody else that would treat you right? Now, this is just it's a dumb example. I can already hear people in the comments, oh, it's a stupid example. I'm just trying to help you understand the difference between what realtors do with for sale by owners so that you can get it. And so going up to a for sale by owner on day one is like them on the altar that they just said yes, and you try to convince them to list their house with you. That's how dumb it is to me. Versus having a mindset of, well, what could happen in the future? Respect what they've decided to do today, which is sell on their own today, Dom. Respect that. Nobody else will. Your competitors will not respect that. They're going to try to come at them to try to explain why that is a dumb decision. That's what causes the conflict. We're going to respect their decision to do this thing on their own, and we're going to present a world in the future that may or may not happen, and we're going to focus on that. So let me pause for a second. I want to get your guys' thoughts on this first initial thought. Ben, let me go to you first.
Yeah, I think to put it in one sentence, I would say you want to be the first voice and you want to be the last voice.
Love it.
So that you come into this with the approach of, this is going to be a courtship. It's not going to be, a quick exchange.
I love that. The first voice and the last voice. Dominic, I don't know if we've ever heard of that before, but Dominic, what are your thoughts on this initial point?
Yeah. So my favorite thing, and you actually said it there in your intro, is that if you are the first voice and you are still there at week 6, 7, 8, when they call you to say, hey, I'd like you to come and talk to us about listing the house, it's pretty much yours to lose and a formality at that point, because you have already been their agent the whole time. They didn't know they needed an agent. So when it doesn't work out, I mean, the competition's pretty slim.
Yeah, that's exactly right. That's exactly right. So let's get a little bit more specific and tactical for the audience for their sake. So what I mean by that is, and I think people struggle with this every day, this misconception around lead generation. And what I mean by that is, of course, we're looking for appointments. But the vast majority of time, if you look at the ratios, an appointment is not set and people aren't doing the next best thing, which is to generate a lead. You know, we call it proactive lead generation, aka prospecting. And I think that this all or nothing mindset is really, really holding a lot of agents back from reaching their potential, which is the all or nothing is I'm either going to get an appointment on this call or I get nothing on this call. Well, there's a huge in between. In fact, I believe your potential lives in the middle. Your potential lives in the middle, because if you just look at the likelihoods of things happening to call somebody randomly out of the blue, well, Dominic, it may take you 20, 25 conversations to set a good listing appointment these days, right? Somewhere in that ballpark, would that be fair?
Yeah.
Well, and this is my argument to all the other agents. Well, what about the other 24 conversations? Well, I didn't get the appointment, right? But time's going to go by. Like, those people probably end up selling a house at some point in the future. And specifically with the for sale by owner, I look at the initial conversation as a sorting conversation, a red gumball, blue gumball conversation. And what we're looking to do specifically is we're looking to do a couple things. In the audience, you can write this down as a checklist. We're going to contact every for sale by owner. You can either do that at the door. You could do that over the phone. You could do that in text. You can do that in email. You can do that in direct message. We're looking to see of the for sale by owners that hit the market, A, which ones are open to the idea of a buyer's agent bringing them a buyer for the home. Well, why, Brandon? I thought you talked about we're not looking to bring a buyer. We're not looking to bring a buyer. We're looking to see which for sale by owners in the market are already 50% there from a belief standpoint of what we can do to serve them. So if you got 10 for sale by owners, 8 or 9 of them are open to the idea of a real estate professional bringing the buyer to the home. That's a good thing for you. And I'll explain to you more why in a second. Number two, we're looking to see of those for sale by owners, which ones, if they do not end up selling a house on their own, would be open to the idea of hiring a real estate agent to represent them in the sale of their home, aka listing the property. Cool, that's number two. And then number three, of those for sale by owners, which ones aren't obligated to a real estate agent already? If you follow just that framework, what you're going to find is, okay, I'm just sorting these through. I'm just sorting through. If you've got 10 for sale by owners in a month, well, maybe you end up with 4 or 5, half of them that fit that criteria. And we're putting that 5 into your pipeline. And that becomes your for sale by owner conversion pipeline. So it makes it really simple on what is the goal with this first conversation. And then obviously we can talk about motivation and all that stuff. But if you just follow those three things, I think it keeps it really simple. Dominic, your thoughts on that?
Yeah, no, I mean, listen, you're wrapping this up pretty neatly. That's exactly how it's gone the whole time I've been working with for sale by owners. You're never going to get them all. You're always going to qualify a bunch that do fit that criteria. You're not going to get all of those either. Some of them are going to sell on their own. Some of them will find somebody that they're a better match for. And then if you keep those people in the pipeline, the people that are coming out the end of the pipeline that are a fit present opportunities, listing opportunities for you. And in the meanwhile, you're meeting new people on the back end of that. And you just keep moving them through the pipeline. And that's how we've always done it for years and years and years.
Yeah, that's exactly right. So now let me talk about the next point of what I would call FSBO conversion. And we won't have time to get through all of them, but I want to talk about this other big idea. This should help the real estate agents in general in their business, but that is having a service or a servant mentality. And this is another one where I think real estate agents have a really, really tough time with. You know, there's all kinds of people coming out now talking about this, but you don't really see it in practice in our business. Like, Gary Vee's got a great book, right? What is it? Jab, 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 right hook.
Yep.
And the whole idea around that is to serve people in a way that when they're ready to transact, that obviously you've earned the business because everybody else has led with their hands out wanting to take something from you. And nothing is more true than converting a for sale by owner. Here's what I mean. I try to come up with these cute little sayings, and this one is be their real estate agent while they believe they don't need one, so that when the day, or if the day comes rather, where they look to hire one, that you become the obvious choice. And so what does that mean? That means that if you could just remove the mindset of your selfish interest on what's in it for me. How do I get a commission check? If you could just remove that for just a couple of weeks, I think your entire business will change. Meaning, how do I just help this person? How do I truly, truly help this person sell this property on their own? How do I do that? Well, Brandon, why in the world would I want to do that? Well, I'm just telling you that, you know, it's the law of reciprocity. You cannot fight it, right? So this is offering them advice. This is offering them signage. This is offering to be a second set of eyes. This is offering to do some open house events on their behalf. I cannot tell you how many agents try to go after for sale by owners and leave half the opportunity on the table, which is to help them secure a house to purchase. Nobody even talks about this, but so many for sale by owners that end up selling on their own, well, what do we learn? They don't have a real estate agent. And so there's that piece of it, A. But more importantly, we're talking about listings. The ones that don't succeed in selling on their own, you have already secured the business, to Dominic's point, which means you don't need to even have a compelling presentation to go out there and earn this business. Most for sale by owner conversion happen as a byproduct of a come list me phone call. Dominic and Ben, you guys have been doing this for years and years and years. Ben, can you speak to this idea of serving the consumer while they're trying to do this on their own, and what that means to you?
This is not a tactic, I would say, first and foremost. I think we've heard from people that are struggling with it, and even this is where I kind of first started. Well, you have to do this truly believing that you can help them sell on their own. Because if you go into this thinking this is a tactic and you're like, well, Brandon, what if they do? And you're trying to hold stuff back, like they can feel that. And guess what? If they do sell on their own and you helped them, like you said, you can secure them helping them buy a home, because they clearly don't have an agent if they just sold on their own. And then think about all the referrals that you can get when you just blow the top off. You just help somebody and got nothing from it. But ultimately, yes, it does result in a lot of times them not getting to the finish line, and you've already won their trust because you've given with nothing in return.
Yeah, we just had a FSBO mastermind inside of our coaching group, and that is exactly, I almost forgot to say that, Ben, to your point, is one of our agents, I think he closed 51 FSBOs last year, and which tells you that a lot of what we're talking about ends up turning into business, but even the ones that don't, he got a lot of referrals from for sale by owners because of this act of service. And it's just a different way to do business, because, you know, one of the things that we teach all the time is to help these for sale by owners with marketing. They just don't know what they don't know. And that has, you know, I'll leave his name out of it, but with the agent I'm talking about, one of the things that he does is he offers to write their Zillow description, right? To help them position the property better. And so these are all things that help to serve the for sale by owner. Dominic, what is your thoughts on this point?
Yeah, I think I would summarize this with one of the core principles that you've been teaching all along since you and I have been working together, and that is it all comes down to being detached from the outcome. Are you going to go into this and go into it with a service mindset, and you're going to do the things that you do for this person just like you would do for a client of yours, and whatever the outcome is, it matters, but it doesn't matter, right? It's not going to affect the service that you provide. You're going to provide that top level class A service. And if it ends up turning into a transaction for you with this person at this moment, fabulous. If it never turns into anything ever, that's okay too. But the truth is, it's probably going to pay you back somewhere along the line.
Yeah. And that's how we have to treat our entire business. I mean, when we talk about, you're talking about client acquisition, lead generation, this is the strategy. Whether you're going to make content, prospect, network, referral partners, you must serve first if you think you're going to get anything in return. You know, I mean, that is just the nature of business. And so it's not just a for sale by owner thing. But I want to address something that I just heard somebody in the comments make in the future. I just told the future just now. And that is, well, what would you say then, Brandon, if a for sale by owner says, well, why are you doing all of this for me? Like, what's in it for you? And I love this question. because it's your opportunity to be honest and tell the truth. And you tell the for sale by owner, well, listen, the reason why I'm doing this is some for sale by owners such as yourself end up selling on their own. And if you do, phenomenal. But if you don't, I would love the opportunity to earn your business one day in the event that you don't. And I'm okay either way. Now, you know, Dr. Cialdini talks about this in his book when he talks about reciprocity. It's about transparent reciprocity, meaning if you don't communicate that way, then people start to say, well, why is this guy doing this? Why is he being so nice to me? But when you communicate it clearly to say, listen, here's my intention. I'm happy to help you out, because sometimes, Dominic, people that sell their own home in Boise, Idaho, fail to do so sometimes. And I don't know if that'll be the case for you or not. I don't know. But in that event, if I can be somebody who can help you along the way, then perhaps you might be open to the idea of giving me the opportunity to earn your business in the future. Maybe that happens, maybe it doesn't, but that is why I'm more than happy to try and help you through this process and be that second set of eyes for you. And if we never do business together, that's perfectly fine too, because guess what? You may run into people in the future that need a real estate professional, and maybe throughout this, I've earned your trust enough to mention my name. Does that make sense? Right? And then you gain agreement with the prospect and they say, that's a win-win. That's a win-win. I can't argue with that. I cannot argue with that. Ben, your thoughts on that?
No, I think that's exactly how we have to approach it. And we have to be transparent, because if you're not, then that does lead to, okay, what do you have? What's the trick here? What's going on? You feel something, you got to say it. And that's just kind of laying that out from the start.
Yeah. And you can't just be the nice guy or the nice girl, because you won't earn business by just being nice. Yeah. I think a lot of people who we've coached over the years is like, dude, I'm doing everything you're saying, right? But have you been intentional around what it is? Have you offered to serve somebody? The only way you could serve somebody in our industry is the listing and selling of a home. Have you offered that up? Just by being nice doesn't do it either.
And that's the key. Like, you have to ask every time. That's how, back to your original analogy, you get stuck in the friend zone. You never do get that opportunity later, is because you aren't clear with your intentions.
Yep, spot on. Now, I wanna talk about a couple things that I think other agents also struggle with. They say to themselves, well, how is it that you guys always talk about that real estate agents can serve for sale by owners from the standpoint of, if the for sale by owner can sell on their own and they have to pay us a commission to do so, how does the for sale by owner win here? I want to talk about this. This is like the big mindset around why agents don't even go after for sale by owners, because they don't understand what I'm about to explain. They haven't really understood how it is that we can actually provide value to a for sale by owner. Their mindset, their belief, the three of us have dealt with this hundreds of times. I've had real estate agents who I've coached say, dude, I don't even believe that I can provide a for sale by owner a value. How can I provide them value, dude? Like, they want $300,000 for their home. If I sell their house for $300,000 and I charge X percent, how? I don't understand, Brandon. What am I missing here? Okay, first things first. This is like the first time I thought about this, I'm like, this is the end of the conversation. But with inside of this context, if the for sale by owner has not sold the home at whatever price and you have, value has been created. Let me explain. If the for sale by owner says, well, how is it that you're going to be able to help net me more money? Or how is it that why would it make sense for me, Dominic, to hire you when I could just sell this on my own and save $10,000 in commission? Well, in doing so, they haven't produced the result yet. So in other words, it would be like, well, Dominic, that's exactly what I'm saying. If you're able to do so, you are 100% correct that it doesn't make sense for you to hire me. That is exactly what it is that I'm saying. And I don't care what other real estate agents tell you. If you can go out there and sell your house at $300,000 with no real estate agents, you could do the math. You're saving money. I'm talking about in a world where you cannot. And therefore, hiring a professional to offer a service to procure to get you the result that you want, of course, there's an exchange of value. and therefore compensation, at least a conversation around compensation, is reasonable. It's reasonable. You see, in other words, let me just make this real simple. If for sale by owner tries to get 300,000, cannot, tries everything they can for 2.5 months, just can't do it. They hire you and you sell it at $300,000 or more, you deserve to get paid. You deserve to get paid. That's how you help somebody win. It's not just a simple math problem. The for sale by owner has not got the result. So yeah, it's easy to say, well, if they sell at 300,000 and I sell at 300,000, they're going to get a lot more on their own. Right. But they haven't got the result. They haven't sold at 300,000. So yeah, you can't just fictitiously create these worlds. If you get the result that somebody else can't get on their own, of course there's value there and you deserve to get paid. That's my thought on that. Donald, let me go to you first.
Well, I'm just thinking back to our first conversation together years and years ago, and you really emphasized, because this was a mindset problem for me with for sale by owners as well way back when, and you said back then, yes, if they sell on their own, if you said that over and over again, if they sell on their own, sure, of course they're better off doing it, but they haven't accomplished that yet. And that's what our value is. And that's the mindset piece, right? I mean, there's not really anything else to add to that other than that you have to go into it with that mindset that your value comes around when they can't achieve what it is that they are trying to achieve. And most of the time we know that statistically they aren't able to do that.
I look at this the same way as a coaching relationship with real estate agents. I'll get on this quick and I'll move off of it. But this is the conversation we have every day with real estate agents. It's, and we've done it over 6,000 times. A real estate agent that's making $80,000 a year, who's concerned about paying us $5,000, $10,000, $15,000 a year for coaching, and then when they do end up making $300,000 in income, I say, is it worth it? I mean, you tell me, is it worth it? You've been trying this for 14 years on your own. You've been making 60, 80 grand. And then we work together for 1 year and you end up making 325 and you invest $10,000 a year in coaching. Is it worth it? You got to decide that, right? This is the same thing. Do I deserve to get paid if I help you make four times as much money for you and your family than you could have on your own? Do I deserve to get paid? And I believe that when you have an equal exchange of value, that is the premise of a good business relationship where both parties say, yeah, there's value here. I'm happy to pay the fee. I'm happy to pay the fee. That's what we're talking about in for sale by owner relationship, is for the real estate agent to be the coach. Let me coach you up. Let me coach you through this process. And if I can help you get the result that you couldn't get on your own, do I deserve to get paid? And I'll ask a for sale by owner that. You know, and you'll find out, am I dealing with a sane, reasonable human? And you could decide yes or no. Okay, so that's the first point. The second point is this. I love asking this question to a for sale by owner, even to myself, even as a real estate agent from mindset perspective. And the first time I heard somebody say this as a new real estate agent, it made so much sense. If you think about what the for sale by owner wants to occur, which is to have a buyer approach them and have no realtor involved whatsoever. Like, that's the ideal world that the for sale by owner wants, right? And then you ask this question, based on how buyer agency works today, that could be different here soon, but based on how it's been over the last 50 years or whatever, what would be the reason a buyer would forego representation from a real estate agent and shop for sale by owners specifically? What would be the reason a human would do that, Dom?
Because they think they're going to get a deal.
That's it. It's the same reason why when people shop for a used car, go to people selling on their own versus a dealership. Why? Because you cannot haggle with a dealership the same way you can direct with the owner. This is the same thing. The for sale by owner buyer who says, all right, let me go to these for sale by owners first. I'm a savvy buyer. Let me go do this on my own. They believe they're going to get a deal. So the premise that the for sale by owner seller has that I'm going to save money is oftentimes eaten up by the buyer that they think that they want. Because why would that buyer pay you retail? Why would I pay you retail for sale by owner when every other house is listed by a professional real estate company and I can't get the deal with them? That's why I'm going to you. You have a sign in your front yard that says you're not paying real estate commissions. Why would I pay you your premium price? Which is the result of why we see for sale renters that do end up selling on their own sell for far less than market value. So the money they think they're being saved gets eaten up by the buyer they think they want. And the first time I thought about that, I'm like, wow, the very thing that the for sale renter thinks they want goes against their own interest to get it. Ben, have you ever thought about that? Like, wow, you just got what you wanted and it was worse for you.
Yeah, it's because of risk, right? Like that buyer is coming to you and saying, yeah, I'll buy your used car. I'll work directly to you, but they're enduring some risk to do so versus, hey, why wouldn't I just go to the dealership? Why wouldn't I just go work with an agent and pay more? Because you're lessening that risk, essentially.
I don't know.
Is that, do you
yeah,
think
that's exactly right. It's the perception the consumer has when a house
and
is listed with
it.
When it's listed with a real estate professional, there's a set of standards that we abide by, right? There's procedures, there's processes, there's disclosures. So the perception that the buyer has is they feel safer versus just buying some house from some random person off of Craigslist, you know, for sale by owner. That doesn't seem right as professional. And it's because of this. It's because of the law of large numbers. You see, when a property is listed with a real estate professional and it's marketed to all potential buyers, that in it by itself drives the price up of anything. We already know that about marketing 101. And so that's the other thing that the for sale buyer doesn't get to benefit from. Don, does that make sense?
Yeah, I was just smiling because think to yourself of all the Monday calls you've made to for sale by owners, the hundreds and thousands of calls you've made over the years. And when you ask them, hey, how'd it go this weekend? Any offers come in? And they tell you about the offers they got. And it's always something like, yeah, I got an offer. I'm like, oh, well, that doesn't sound very promising. What's going on? Well, they want owner carry, or they want to lease it, or they want to do some other shady rent to own type of situation. And the reason those people approach for sale by owners is because those buyers are not well qualified enough to warrant the services of a professional buyer's agent, right? They can't qualify with a bank, or they're trying to get some sketchy deal together, and a professional real estate agent just doesn't accept those kinds of buyers, or they shouldn't. So that's a theme, right? Whenever you call a for sale by owner with that Monday call after the weekend, man, I've just had hundreds of those conversations.
It's a great point. And then you can just, you know, ask the for sale by owner a simple question. Listen, let me just ask you this, and I'm good either way, but if a conversation were to be had where I could show you how in which we can handle the sale of your home, Dominic, and resulted in you getting the money that you wanted or more, would it be worth a 15, 20 minute meeting? And if not, it's perfectly fine. You know, if you could just ask a question like that after the for sale by owner, now it'll come full circle, 6-7 weeks into the game when they're getting their head kicked in with realtors and amateurs and investors and lowball offers, they're like, man, yeah, let's meet. Let's talk about it, you know, and we're giving them a level of certainty that removes the stress and the pain of what we know of one of life's biggest stressors, right? It's like death, divorce, and selling a house. You know what I mean? And so it's like, that's the value in which you can offer to a for sale by owner. If you can serve them while they're trying to do this thing on their own, be respectful. Be respectful. Get out of your selfish commission breath neediness. If you can put that aside and serve another human being, put their needs before yours, your needs will be taken care of. That is my belief in this business of real estate sales. Any last thoughts you guys have?
Yeah, I would just challenge people to be the first voice and then be the first face, right? Just this was one point that I had written down that we didn't touch on, but you've got a 5% chance to set an appointment on that first conversation, but a 70% chance to set an ability to get in front of them and tour the home because they expect that to be part of the process of working and gathering buyers and working with a buyer's agent. So just get in front and then serve them along the way and put that opportunity potential down the road.
Yeah, I can't believe we almost forgot that. It's probably the main point. So thanks, Ben, for picking us up. It's probably the main point, right, is to go and meet them, right? Because the seller believes that is part of the process anyway, which oftentimes it is, right? Every house that's listed in the MLS offers agent previews. This is just a normal part of selling a property. So it's normal for them to hear from real estate salespeople that want to come and see the house. Like, that's normal. So any last thoughts that might help the audience, Dominic, on your side?
Yep. Just keep in mind, as a real estate agent, whether you're brand new or been in this forever, for sale by owners are the only lead source that already has their hand high in the air and they are actively in the process of trying to sell their home. They are the hottest. An expired listing, they've been on the market forever, absentee owners, they're in some part of the process, right? But a for sale by owner, they are freshly into it with their hand raised as high as any lead source can be. They are the best source of opportunity out there in the market right now today.
And let's get to work. So first I'll break down every line and then I'll give you an actual live role play at the end. Hi, name? This is how you start off every single phone call to a for sale by owner. We no longer ask, hey, how are you doing today? It's too salesy. The first person's name is the most beautiful name to them or the most beautiful word to them in the English language. This is gonna help to get their attention. Number two, we're gonna ask a question to the for sale by owner where we know the answer is 100% yes. So we say, this is Brandon. I'm a local realtor and I understand you're selling the house for sale by owner. Is that right? You're using your first name only and I'm a local realtor, not your full company name. And we get right into asking the first question in the script, which is, hey, I'm calling about the home for sale. I understand you're selling it on your own. Is that right? This positions the prospect to start talking right away. Why? Because we know the person asking questions is in control, the one talking is not. Number three is what we call a pattern interrupt. The for sale by owner is not used to hearing what you're about to say. They're used to realtors like you and I calling them, trying to convince them to list their house. You're not gonna do that. You're simply gonna say, Mr. For Sale by Owner, I completely respect the fact that you're selling on your own. A matter of fact, if I was you in this market, I would also be selling my home regardless of what the other realtors are saying. Next, we're now gonna ask a question to see if the for sale by owner is open to ideas, suggestions, recommendations, strategies, tactics on selling their home. We are not saying and we are not suggesting that we have a buyer for the home. We're simply going to ask the for sale by owner, Mr. For Sale by Owner, I'm just curious, are you open to the idea of an agent bringing you a buyer for the home? Why do we ask this question? Because we're curious, we're trying to find out if this for sale by owner that we're talking to right now is open to paying a buyer agent commission, because if they are, we're halfway there. Next, now we've got to find out some motivation around why the for sale by owner is selling. So this is the best way to figure out why they're selling, because if you ask this question the wrong way, you're gonna get rejected. So you say, Mr. For Sale by Owner, I love the neighborhood you're in. From what I see online, your home looks great. I'm just curious, what has you guys thinking about moving? Because what you're doing is you're putting the prospect in a position to say, yes, I know, we love it here too, but, and then that's when the motivation comes out. That's when their goals come out. This is the critical goal, the critical information that you're looking for. Next, line number five, you say, I see. And ideally, when would you like to move? Now we're talking about timing. So now we've got their motivation and their timing. This is gonna give us a lot of information when you set up this phone call in a way to position it as a listing opportunity. This is the most important question in the entire script, so make sure you pay attention. This is when we're gonna find out, do we have a listing opportunity here or do we not? So you're simply gonna say, Mr. or Mrs. For Sale by Owner, listen, the market is great right now. Chances are you're gonna sell this house on your own. I'm curious if in 30 days, for whatever reason, you're unsuccessful selling, At that point, would you consider maybe meeting with a realtor to look at some other options? Now, we're asking this hypothetically. The power in asking hypothetical questions as you learn more and more about my reverse selling strategy puts the prospect in a position to answer the question. Why? Because there's no threat. And so we're asking them about something that we've positioned will never happen. We said, Mr. Prospect, chances are this is never going to occur. You are absolutely gonna sell this house on your own. This sets us up to ask the qualifying question so we get the answer we're looking for. And it's in a hypothetical situation, so there's no threat for the for sale by owner to answer. So what you're gonna find is that most for sale by owners say, yeah, you know what? If we can't sell this house on our own, we'd be open to looking at some other options. That's number one. Number two, what we're also listening for is, do they have an agent that they would be obligated to work with? So if they respond with, you know, yeah, we'd be open. If we can't sell this thing on, we'd be open to looking at some other options. That's a great opportunity potentially for a listing appointment. However, if they respond with, listen, if we can't sell this on our own, we're gonna list it with my friend Bob, we're gonna list it with my mom, we're gonna list it with my sister, you're listening for that on this question. Now, if the for sale by owner responds positive to that question, you're gonna respond and say, great, well, let's do this, and Bob, I really don't mind. I'm gonna send you an email with my for sale by owner backup plan. Take a look at it, and if it's something you want to review with me later down the road, I'd be happy to do so. Fair enough. This is the best script when talking to for sale by owners to generate the lead, get their email address, and get them to agree to continue communicating long-term. So you're gonna do just that. When you hang up the phone, you're gonna email the for sale by owner your backup plan, but we're not done yet. This is where you're going to position the call to set up a potential listing appointment on the very first call. You're then going to ask the for sale by owner this question. It all comes down to how you deliver this question. You're gonna say, Mr. For Sale by Owner, I'm just curious, while I have you on the phone now, if I could show you this plan and walk you through how my For Sale by Owner plan works, and the numbers made sense, I'm just curious if this is something that you might be open to reviewing now versus waiting in the future, because listen, you're not gonna do anything unless it makes sense. Am I right? So we've positioned that call, we've positioned that script or this situation for the prospect in a win-win situation, because we're not using high pressure language. We're giving the prospect the illusion of control. We're putting the prospect in a position where they don't feel threatened to meet with us. We're positioning this potential meeting as just another option. But when you ask the question, so we've asked them about, hey, are you open to looking at something else in the future? They say yes. We turn right back around and we say, got it. Well, Bob, while I've got you now, I'm just curious, if I could show you this plan now, break down the numbers, and it all made sense, is this something you'd potentially look at now versus waiting for the future? Because listen, you're not gonna do anything unless it makes sense. Am I right? Because if you stop too early there, you're gonna potentially get the prospect to say no. So what you're going to do is you're gonna end that script when you're asking for the listing interview or a chance to show them what you can do or a chance to interview to get the listing. You're gonna end that by saying, Mr. Prospect, because listen, you're not gonna do anything unless it makes sense, am I right? And they always say yes. They have to say yes to that. So here's the entire script so you can hear it and how it gets delivered. Ring, ring, ring. Hi, Bob. Bob, this is Brandon. I'm a local realtor. I was calling about the property on Main Street for sale. And Bob, I understand you're selling that on your own. Is that right? Got it. And Bob, listen, I absolutely respect the fact that you're selling this house on your own, regardless of what other agents are calling and telling you. I'm just curious, are you open to the idea of an agent bringing you a buyer for the home? Perfect. And Bob, I'm looking at the house now online. It looks gorgeous. I actually love the neighborhood you're in. what has you thinking about selling? Ah, that makes sense. And ideally, when would you like to move? Makes sense. And Bob, with the market being so hot right now, the reality is you're gonna most likely sell this house immediately on your own with no problems. I'm just kind of curious, if in 30 days, for whatever reason, you can't sell the home, at that point, would you consider maybe meeting with a realtor to look at some other options? Okay, great. Well, let's do this. I'll send you an email with my for sale by owner backup plan. Take a look at it, Bob, and if it's something you want to review later down the road, we can do that. Fair enough? Now, what's the best email for you typically? Got it. Now, Bob, while I have you now, I'm just curious, if I could share this plan with you, walk you through a strategy and numbers that potentially made sense, is this something that you might consider reviewing now versus waiting for some time in the future? Because listen, you're not gonna do anything unless it makes sense. Am I right?
Your call has been forwarded to an automatic voice message system.
Just hit the button, go to the next one. Adam, good morning. This is Brandon. I'm a local realtor. How are you?
Good.
Doing well. Hey, quickly, I just saw your property on Rachel Lane go up for sale. I know you're selling it yourself. And I'm just curious, are you open to working with a buyer's broker if we have a fully qualified buyer at this time?
No, sorry, not at this time.
Hey, no worries. Let me ask you this. Let me ask you a quick question.
I'm sorry, I got another call that I've been waiting for 8:30, but I apologize. You call me back later, though.
All right, sounds good. Appreciate you.
Bye.
Yeah, bye now. All right, put him in my follow-up. We move on to the next one. Not everyone's gonna fit our model, and that's okay.
Hello?
Hi, good morning. Is this Nancy?
It is.
Nancy, this is Brandon. I'm a local realtor. How are you? Good. I saw your property on Congress go up for sale. I know you're selling it yourself, which is great. I was just curious, are you open to working with an agent if we brought you a fully qualified buyer at this time?
Absolutely.
Oh, perfect. Okay, good. And do you live in a property now?
No, the property is empty right now.
It's empty now. Okay, so.
Sorry. Yep. And okay. It has immediate occupancy.
Oh, perfect. Okay, good.
There's no mortgage on it. It's free and clear, and so the best scenario would be a cash buyer. It's free and clear. A couple papers. We're done.
No kidding. Yeah. No, that's great. That's really good. You know, and how much are you asking for the property? Is it 185?
We're asking 185. Yes.
Okay. No, that's a great price. Seems to be a really, really good price. And properties right there are selling really, really well. So I'm sure you're not going to have any problems selling it on your own. But let me ask you this. I mean, if for some reason you can't find, you know, the best buyer to give you that 185 or more, would you consider other options in the future?
By that, what do you mean?
Well, let's just pretend for a second you have it on the market for a few weeks, you're not getting any offers. Would you consider interviewing an agent like myself down the road to get you the highest price?
Well, I'll tell you, we wanted to just try selling it on our own, but we have a family member who is a realtor with Keller Williams. And so if we were to list the property, we would give it to that person.
Oh, no, that makes a lot of sense. And surely, right, you want to work with family, and that family member would want you to do what's best for you. Is that right? Yeah, that makes a lot of sense. So we work with a lot of for sale by owners. If we ever got to that point where you said, hey, I'm going to look at putting this property on the market with a realtor, you know, you're obviously going to interview a few different people. Is that correct?
Nope.
No, you would just...
With our family.
That makes...
If we didn't have a family member, yes, we would interview a couple of people and see who's the best option, sure.
Makes sense. Okay, good. Well, listen, I'm going to see what we can do to bring you a buyer in the meantime. And then I will stay in touch and we'll go from there. Fair enough?
That would be great. I'm sorry, your name again is?
Yeah, my name is Brandon.
Brandon? Okay, Brandon. Yep. Give me a call if you have an interested buyer. We are more than willing to work with a realtor, and we've already told realtors and other realtors that we would do the usual 3% for a realtor, bringing a buyer.
Yeah, that's very, very generous. So thank you for that, and we'll get to work right away.
Thank you, Brandon.
You're welcome. Best of luck. Talk to you soon. Bye. Okay. Bye. Bye now. A nice, pleasant conversation, but we get into those qualifying questions. You see me get into those qualifying questions and find out really quickly, right? They've got a family member, right? I even asked another question on top of that, right? To see if she'd be open to interviewing me, even though she has a family member, and she's not. So that's okay. We just keep moving on. Hi, good morning. It's Brandon. I'm a local realtor. How are you?
I'm fine.
Good. Hey, I was calling. I saw the property on Cotter Avenue go up for sale. Is this the owner?
Yes.
Oh, perfect. Okay, good. It looks like a great house. I know you're selling the house by owner, which is great. I was just curious. Yeah, are you open to working with an agent if we brought you a fully qualified buyer?
No, because then I still have to pay your fee.
Yeah. No. Sure. No, that makes sense. I mean, can I ask you this, how long you might try and sell the house completely on your own before you'd be open to looking at other options?
I really don't know, because it's not like I have to sell it, so.
That makes sense.
I don't know.
Yeah, I guess here's a different question. I mean, if the market's so good, you'll probably have really no issues selling it on your own. If you go a couple weeks or a couple months and you have no buyers, would you consider some other options at that point?
I don't think so.
Then you just stay put.
No, I'm just gonna hold down and see.
Okay, so if you can't sell the property on your own with no agents at all, then you just not sell it at all.
Right.
Okay, and what was your first name?
Colleen.
Okay, my first name is Brandon. Colleen, what I'll do is, if you're okay with it, I'll just stay in touch. And if you need something throughout the process, like a purchase contract or the seller's disclosure statements, anything that you need help with, Colleen, feel free to ask me. Is that fair?
You know what? I have a daughter that does all that stuff, so, you know, I really don't need anybody.
Okay, good. Well, hey, best of luck to you.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome. Bye now.
Bye-bye.
Just seeing who fits the funnel and who doesn't. It's all.
Hello.
Hi there. Good morning. It's Brandon. I'm a local realtor. How are you?
Hey, good. How are you?
Doing well. The property on O'Neill Circle, saw that go up for sale. I know you're selling it yourself. I was just curious.
Yeah,
just curious if you were open to working with a buyer's agent if we did bring you a fully qualified buyer at this time.
Yes.
You are. Okay, very good. And do you currently live in the property now, or?
No.
This was like an investment property?
Yes.
I see. Okay, good. And you're asking 119, is that correct?
Yes.
That makes sense. Hey, and I'm sorry, what was your first name?
First name is Hassan.
Hassan, my name is Brandon. Can I ask you,
hi,
nice to meet you. You know, these properties, these properties here in Rochester, they tend to sell fairly quickly. Let me ask you, if for some reason you can't get the price you're looking for on your own, would you consider interviewing an agent like myself down the road to actually put it on the market, go find you the highest paying buyer?
That's fine, but I want to first give it like a 1 month period to try to sell it myself first.
Absolutely. No, totally makes sense. What I'd like to do is maybe stop by one day, maybe either tomorrow or early next week just to take a quick peek at it. If I was to stop by and find some time, are you around in the afternoons or evenings better for you typically?
In the afternoons better.
In the afternoons. Okay. Let me see. I might be able to stop by tomorrow afternoon, maybe 3-4 o'clock. Would that work for you?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, like 3:30 or 4. Yeah.
Okay. Let's just plan on 3:30 for now. What I'd like to do is walk through the property, see what you have. I'll make some recommendations, and then from there we can get to work. Fair enough?
Sounds good.
All right. So I will. Then what's the best email? I'm going to send you my email, my resume, so you can take a quick peek at that, so you know who's coming by tomorrow. What's the best email for you, Sam?
No, actually, I live in Grand Blanc.
Oh, okay. Okay, great. Yeah, so
it's about half an hour away.
Yeah, makes sense. Well, yeah, I'll look forward to seeing the place tomorrow right around 3:30. I'll give you a call tomorrow just to verify that time still works for me, and then we'll go from there.
Fair enough. Sounds good.
Thanks, Hassan. Have a great day.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Call every lead you have and ask them for an appointment. Then throw away all those leads that are not going to do anything in the next 7 to 10 days.
What you just saw was some of the worst advice ever given to real estate agents in the history of our business. You see, what took me from 20, 30 deals a year to 100 plus deals per year was lead follow-up. You've heard it time and time again, and it is so true. The fortune is in the follow-up. Yet, famous trainers keep telling us that lead follow-up doesn't matter, that following up with leads doesn't matter, that building a database doesn't matter. Well, in this video, I'm gonna share with you my exact system, my exact formula, step-by-step, exactly what I do to convert for sale by owners. And we're starting, you guessed it, right now. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you are looking to grow your real estate agent business, start now by subscribing to my channel, hitting the notification so you never miss one of my training videos. And so today we're gonna break down my entire FSBO follow-up system. This is the holy grail. This is the thing you guys have all been asking me for. This is what you guys have all been waiting for. So I'm gonna show you exactly how this thing works, exactly what I do. And at the end of this video, I will put a link to my schedule below this video if you'd like to learn how to implement this into your business through my For Sale by Owner training program. Schedule a call, learn more, see if it's a fit for you or not, and I'll be looking forward to talking with you after the video. So let's get started. Starting off with why lead follow-up is so important when it comes to converting for sale by owners. There's two things I want you to consider. Number one, when it comes to your lead generation, your prospecting, your marketing efforts, when you're going after for sale by owners or any lead source for that matter, you're for the most part going to be communicating with who? Strangers, right? They don't know you, you don't know them. So I give this example all the time with my students, and that is this. If you're watching this and you're in any type of relationship or you're married, you never, not once, well, if you were, I'd be a little bit scared, but never, not once have I heard someone communicate with their current spouse one time. And that first time that they communicated with their current spouse, let's call it 10 years ago, 20 years ago. And on that first interaction, they got down on one knee, they proposed, and the other person said yes. It doesn't happen that way, does it? No. You met your spouse 5, 10, 20 years ago, however long ago it was. You guys had a nice interaction. You had a nice meeting. You went on a first date. And because things went well, you probably went on a second date. And you started this relationship over time. Then what happens is somebody proposed and you got engaged. And then that engagement lasted for a period of time. And then eventually you got married. Well, what these traditional real estate agent trainers are teaching us, what they're wanting us to do is call absolute strangers and do just that. They want us to call and propose to an absolute stranger. We've never met with them. They've never heard from us before. They don't know us. We don't know them. There's no relationship at all. And they want us to ask them, Mr. and Mrs. Seller,
If I come over today, will you list your home with me today? That is what they're teaching us to do. And I'm here to tell you that that is a very, very difficult thing to do. Wouldn't it make more sense for you to build a relationship over time, put a follow-up system in place, which you're gonna learn here in just a second, so that when the for sale by owner cannot sell their home, that you become the obvious choice and get the listing? That's right. So that's the first thing I want you to consider. The second thing I really want you to consider is this: the likelihood of a for sale by owner listing their property with a real estate agent on day one, two, three, even the first week, it's very, very unlikely. Let's agree to that. Does it happen from time to time? Sure. But I'm talking about the 80%. I'm not talking about solving for the 20% of the time. I'm not talking about what ifs. I'm talking about what happens the majority of the time. It's very rare for a for sale by owner to decide, you know what, I'm gonna sell this thing on my own and then have a complete stranger, which is a realtor, call them, which they don't wanna deal with at all, call them out of the blue, and then agree to list that property with that agent on the first interaction. It's just, there's no magic fairy dust. It just, for the most part, that's not what's happening. That's not what's happening. And if you have any experience calling for sale by owners, you would agree with me so far. So, because we know that, well, why are we trying to list their property within the first day, two, or the first week? You see, the second thing that you need to take away from this video and why lead follow-up is so important is you have every real estate agent that is taking this old advice. They're calling them trying to convince the for sale by owner to list their property within the first week or two. They don't get the listing and they give up. So not you, not after watching this video. After watching this video, you already know the for sale by owner is not going to list their property within the first week or two or three or four. So wouldn't it only make sense that you have a system in your business that allows you to follow up with a great, valuable message over time so that when the day comes, when that for sale by owner says, you know what, I can't do this thing, I give up, I need help, and they start interviewing agents, that you become the obvious choice. You get the phone call, you get the listing. Come on, like, doesn't that make a lot of sense? Of course it does. So those are the two things you have to consider why lead follow-up is so important. So now let's get into the tactics and the strategies and all the stuff you guys have been waiting for. Starting off with tactic number one in my FSBO follow-up system, and that is the handwritten thank you card. After you go to the preview appointment, what I teach all of my students to do is send a handwritten thank you card with a specific message to that for sale by owner after the face-to-face meeting that goes out the same day to the for sale by owner with a token of appreciation. And what I teach my students to do is to include a dollar lottery scratch-off ticket with a specific message. That should be in the hand of the for sale by owner 24 to 48 hours after the initial meeting. Tactic number two in my FSBO follow-up system is the Monday follow-up call. So what I teach, what I built my entire FSBO system on, is this Monday follow-up call. It's got a few different parts to it. And so what it is that I teach my students to do is communicate in such a way on that Monday follow-up call that puts the for sale by owner in a very interesting position mentally. It has them thinking about certain things that we brought up in that face-to-face meeting that creates doubt without threat. Let me say that again. It creates doubt without threatening the for sale by owner, without pressuring the for sale by owner. We're communicating in such a way on that Monday phone call so that the for sale by owner is really thinking to themselves, man, maybe we should get back together. Maybe we should look at some other options. And you'll learn exactly what that looks like, what that sounds like, what that phone call sounds like. If you want to implement this, just schedule a call with me. I'd be happy to kind of walk you through how that whole thing works. Okay, tactic number three, which is my for sale by owner direct mail automation system. So what happens, what all my students do after they join our program, is they get access to a company called Banner Season. Banner Season allows us to create direct mail automation campaigns similar to that of an email, but we send out direct mail. So let me show you this. Hopefully the camera can get that. So the first piece of mail that for sale by owner gets is this nice huge envelope, okay? It's an 8.5 by 11 envelope. And it says right on there, for sale by owner backup plan, okay? So they get this thing, they open it, and it's all nicely designed and branded to the agent. And it talks about our entire for sale by owner backup strategy. What's included, how it works. It differentiates our students from all of the other agents in the marketplace. And then what happens over the course of the next 8 weeks is the for sale by owner will start getting these little nice cards in the mail that kind of spell out our specific for sale by owner backup strategy details and all the things that we offer specifically to a for sale by owner. And so they'll get these cards over the next 8 weeks, really detailing the value that we provide that other agents in the marketplace just cannot provide. And so that's the direct mail system. We use a company called Banner Season to put all of that on automation. Tactic number four in the for sale by owner follow-up system is our Wednesday email. So every Wednesday, we're doing a couple of things. We send the for sale by owner two separate emails. One that has to do with a special report that we send to all for sale by owners to show them how they're positioned in the marketplace against their competition, which are other homes that are selling in their local market. Then the second thing is we have custom created emails that go out automatically that again are providing valuable information, valuable advice, valuable content to the for sale by owner because we want to continue to contribute, right? We're using the law of reciprocity to continue building that relationship with the for sale by owner. So every single Wednesday, me and all of my students are sending these emails out automatically to the for sale by owners that we've met with, the for sale by owners that we are in relationship with, the for sale by owners that we are working with. Because again, the goal of this entire system is that within the next 2-3 weeks after you've met with the for sale by owner or you talk to a for sale by owner and they cannot sell the property on their own, you become the obvious choice. Tactic number five, which is our FSBO Facebook retargeting ad. That's hard to say. But what happens is we teach all of our students to put a Facebook specific ad in front of every for sale by owner in their local market. So how we communicate that ad is just like we do with everything else. We're always leading with contribution. We're always leading with value. Never are we pressuring them to sell their home. We wanna be a resource. We wanna be the source of information that this for sale by owner gets on their journey selling their property on their own until the day they can't do it on their own. And then we come in and help them sell the property. And so on Thursday, we launch a Facebook retargeting ad that goes in their newsfeed of every for sale by owner in the marketplace. Tactic number six is the Friday text message. So what it is that we do and what we teach all of our students to do is send every for sale by owner in the marketplace a specific message every Friday through text that keeps the agent top of mind, that offers a unique value proposition to have the for sale by owner compelled to want to meet with you again. And so that text message goes out every single Friday to all of the for sale by owners in the marketplace. Tactic number seven, and our last one in my FSBO follow-up system, is our open house strategy. So we're teaching all of our students, and this is what agents on my team, and the exact same thing that I did for years and years and years, is follow a specific process focused on this backup strategy, right? So I'm just knocking everything over, this backup strategy. And so we teach exactly what to do, how to then visit all of the for sale by owners in your marketplace that are having open houses, what to do, what to say, what to bring, how that meeting should go. And you're gonna do that every Saturday. Why the preview appointment? You see, so many real estate agent trainers and speakers and gurus want you to only go and meet with people when they are pre-qualified. Now, my problem with that theory is that, number one, it's very difficult to call for hours and hours and hours and hours, day after day, looking for somebody who will tell you, yes, they will list their home with you today if they like what you have to say, if they like what you have to offer. That's really difficult to do, and it really doesn't work that way anymore. So why the preview appointment? Because like I teach all of my students in my training program, a face-to-face meeting changes everything. This has probably happened to you before as well. When you get face-to-face with a prospect, it's completely different than what you anticipated over the phone or over email, over text, isn't it? That's why the face-to-face preview appointment, especially with for sale by owners, is so powerful. You can go there, establish the relationship, and so that when they're ready to list their property, you're not going there to force them to list. When they are ready on their own, you become the obvious choice. Next, how to properly set up the face-to-face appointment. You see, what a lot of people are teaching you when it comes to previewing FSBOs is tell them you have a buyer and that you want to see the home for potential buyers. Wrong. Don't do that ever. I don't teach any of my students to do that. What I want you to do is I want you to have conversations focusing around what I call the FSBO backup plan. And so I'll put a link below this video with my entire script book so you can see what exactly I say to set up a preview appointment under the pretense that we're only there to discuss the for sale by owner backup strategy in the event they can't sell their home on their own. We're not going there to trick them that we have a buyer. We never do that. We're going there for the specific reason to discuss our for sale by owner backup plan to give the consumer something to consider if what they're trying on their own doesn't work. My entire system and strategy is built off of a low pressure, high relationship based selling system that I call reverse selling. And so the whole entire point of setting the preview appointment up this way is that you set expectations right from the get-go. Next. What do you bring with you at the FSBO preview appointment? There are four things I want you to bring when you go and visit a for sale by owner to discuss the FSBO backup strategy. Number one is the FSBO marketing packet. And so I'll show you just a quick glimpse of that right now and kind of what that looks like. And all of my students get access to all of these docs I'm about to show you. But the number one thing I want you to bring is the FSBO marketing kit. And this is where you're going to show the for sale by owner all of the different marketing tips and ideas and thoughts from you to them, pouring into the relationship through the law of reciprocity, through contribution, giving them tangible value. You're going to give them this nice packet of information that will help the consumer sell on their own. Yes, you heard that right. Why do we want to try to help them sell on their own? Because if they can't, you guessed it, who becomes the obvious choice? You do. The next thing I want you to bring is your FSBO listing presentation. This is going to outline, this entire presentation is going to outline all of the special things that your FSBO backup plan presentation will include so that when the FSBO appointment goes the way that I'm going to show you here in just a second, you can walk them through your FSBO backup plan. Number three, I want you to bring a CMA, a comparative market analysis. And I want you to show them what's going on in the marketplace. Number four, I want you to bring all of the real estate documents that this consumer is going to need in order to successfully sell their home on their own. The purchase agreement, the disclosures, any other disclosures or documents that your state requires. Bring them blank copies of these to use during the selling process. Next, let me walk you through my six-step FSBO preview appointment strategy. Number one is the home tour. For the life of me, I cannot understand why real estate agent gurus and trainers don't want us to take the advantage to tour the home with the consumer. So many of these old school real estate gurus that haven't sold a home in I don't know how long, they say, tour the house by yourself. Tell the consumer to go sit at the kitchen table and tour the home by yourself. huge mistake. What I want you to do is take that opportunity as a first impression opportunity, build rapport, break the ice, and it's your chance to connect with the homeowner so that it starts off the relationship the right way. Number two is the Zillow ad review. What I teach all of my students in my For Sale by Owner training program is how to review the For Sale by Owners Zillow ad so that you can again pour into this relationship with tangible value. You're showing them exactly what to do, what not to do. And I teach you all of this in my training program, exactly what to do with the Zillow ad review. Next, number three is the FSBO CMA presentation. What I share with all my students is exactly how to share the market information so that for the first time maybe ever in the For Sale by Owner's life, they look at you and all real estate agents differently than they ever have in their past. Why? Because through this FSBO CMA presentation, I'm gonna teach you how to present this information in such a way where they're blown away. They don't understand how days on market can contribute to the amount of the offer going to be, right? They don't understand that correlation. And then next, number four, is the FSBO value proposition presentation. This is where you're going to communicate with the For Sale by Owner as a backup strategy, as a backup system, all of the unique things that you offer, that you give in the marketplace that no other real estate agent offers. As an example of that, I offer my smart seller program. I offer my flexible commission system. I offer my no handcuff listing contract. All of these different things separates me from all of the other agents in the marketplace. What's next? Number five. Number five in the face-to-face FSBO appointment strategy is I want you to plant the seed. I want you to concrete plant this seed as you being the obvious choice for the For Sale by Owner backup plan. You see, the whole system, everything that I teach you to do and how to go after For Sale by Owners is all based on a process and a system to be the backup strategy so that you can go there, support the For Sale by Owner to try and help them sell the property on their own. And when the day comes, because we know 80 to 90% of FSBOs don't sell on their own, after 4, 5, 6 weeks in the game, you've been there pouring into the relationship, giving them value, not pressuring them to sell their property. You become the obvious choice to list the property with. So number five is planting that seed, telling the For Sale by Owner, listen, you know, I think today was a great meeting. Hopefully you got a lot out of it. I'll stay in touch with you over the next couple of weeks as you're trying to sell the property on your own. And Bob, Susie, if the day ever comes where you can't sell this on your own, or you start to think, man, maybe we should start looking at some other options, I would like the opportunity to interview for the job of selling your property. Is that fair? And the consumer says, yeah, Brandon, that's fair. That totally makes sense. If we can't sell this thing on our own, sure, we'll give you an opportunity. So that's number five. And then number six is the day you have that FSBO preview appointment, write them a handwritten thank you card with something tangible, whether that be a Starbucks gift card, or what I like to do now is send them a $1 scratch-off lottery ticket and say, hey, best of luck selling your home on your own. And I get that in the mail the exact same day as I have the preview appointment. Now, once you have gone through the six-step face-to-face preview appointment, you're going to put that For Sale by Owner into your follow-up system. This is a system that I've been teaching agents for years, and I'll put a link below this video if you wanna jump on a call and learn more about my FSBO training program. But you're going to follow up with this For Sale by Owner, and I'll make another video on exactly how to follow up with the For Sale by Owner. But now your job is to follow up and do everything that you said you were gonna do at the face-to-face appointment so that again, when 3, 4, 5, 6, 9 weeks goes by, you've been following up consistently, the For Sale by Owner can't sell the property on their own, what do you think is going to happen? You're gonna start getting phone calls, what we call come list me calls. You're gonna start getting phone calls from For Sale by Owners in your marketplace to say, you know what? You were the only agent that didn't pressure me to sell my house like all the other agents. You helped me along the way. Can you come over and list our property? Can you come over and share with us what you can do to get our property sold? So what I want you to do right now is I put a link below this video. You can either schedule a call with me to kind of learn about my For Sale by Owner training program, which will help you implement everything I talked about this video today. And then in the comments section below, for the next hour, I'm gonna be doing a live Q&A. So if you wanna chat, ask me any question that you want, either about anything I covered in this video or anything that I can do to help grow your real estate agent business. In the comments section below, ask me any question that you want.
Hello.
Hey, Tawana.
Hi, Brandon, how are you?
I'm good, and yourself?
Okay.
Good. Catch you at a bad time?
Actually, I'm at lunch and I'm still in Texas.
Oh, okay. No worries. Are you back in town next week still? Is that the plan?
Yes.
All right. Go ahead.
Okay, I'm sorry. No, I was out to call you when I get back, or if you need to talk to me now, I don't know.
Nope, I'll just touch base and see, you know, I'll touch base with you next week, and then we'll firm up some time to get together next week and go through all the details, and we'll get to work.
Okay, sounds good.
Sound good?
Yep, sounds good.
Thank you so much. Have a good week.
Oh. You too.
All right, bye-bye. Just pushing people through the funnel. That's all I'm doing, pushing people through the funnel. The whole thing is you just got to be consistent to build a nice, huge, awesome, mature funnel. Come on.
Hello.
Hi, Hassan.
Yes.
Hey, Brandon, how are you?
Very good. How are you?
I'm doing great. Doing great. Hey, I just wanted to be brief. Did you accept an offer on your condo in Rochester yet?
No.
You didn't? Okay. Yeah, I know I was going to try to get there last Friday, but I didn't get a chance. And so I wanted just to follow up and see where you're at with things and see if you might be open to other options or just kind of get your overall feedback.
Yeah, I want to wait another week or maybe two before I change the strategy or hire a sales agent or something.
Makes sense. Totally makes sense. Are you, and I hate to have you, I know you live in Grand Blanc. Do you work closer to the condo? Like, would you be able to meet me on your way home from work so you wouldn't have to drive all the way out there?
No, actually, I work in Grand Blanc.
Oh, you work in Grand Blanc. Okay. All right. I would love to still see it this week. Are you going to be around the area at all, like Thursday or Friday again?
I don't know, but I'll let you know if someone calls and want to see it, like, one of these days.
Oh, that's perfect.
I can call you and we can meet there.
All right. I'm going to, that's perfect. And I'll just probably follow up with you on Wednesday or something just to touch base to see what the rest of your week looks like. Fair enough?
Sounds good.
All right, Hassan, best of luck, and I'll be in touch.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you. Bye-bye. Bye. That's a condo I really want to list. And you just heard him, right? So he just keep touching base, keep building on the relationship. He wants another week or two before changing his strategy. And that's how this whole thing goes. This is what I do every day, all day. Call, go on appointments. No appointments. No appointments. I try to call more. Hi, Julie. It's Brandon. Hope all is well. Hey, just wanted to follow up with you guys. Had a great meeting, obviously, with you guys last week. Just seeing if there's any questions I could answer for you at this time. Give me a call when you can. Hi, Jack. Good afternoon. It's Brandon. Hope all is well. Listen, I just wanted to follow up with you and see kind of what the status is of your property that you're thinking about listing. Give me a call back, Jack, when you can. Nothing exciting here, right? Just boring, mundane work. Setting in appointments, going on those appointments. Hi, George. Brandon Mulrennan. How are you?
Hi, okay. Thank you.
Good, good. Hey, I just wanted to follow up. I know I was trying to get in touch with you last week and see what your plans are with your property that you're looking to sell.
I'm listing it with another realtor.
Oh, good. Okay, and are you guys on the market yet? Is it live on the market?
It is.
It is. Okay, and how much is the asking price now?
$245,000.
Okay, perfect. We'll see what we can do to help you guys get it sold. Thanks, George.
All right, bye.
Yep, bye-bye. There you go. Happens all the time. He listed it with somebody else.
I don't get mad about it. I don't think about it. I don't care about it. All it tells me is for sale by owners are listing their houses with FSBOs or FSBOs are listing their houses with agents every single day. It's just, who's it going to be? And I probably didn't follow up with that guy enough. Again, I call through this folder every Monday, and then I have a daily folder too with a lot less people in it. I'm just moving them from one part of the program to the next.
Hello.
Hi, Gene, Brandon, Mulrennan. How are you?
Oh, I'm good.
Good. Hey, just following up. Did you accept an offer on your property in Wickensham?
No, not yet.
Okay, cool. And I know the last time we talked, we were talking about maybe getting together and talking about some different strategies and tactics. Are you open to that at this point, or what are your thoughts?
We have an agent.
Okay. Did you guys get it listed?
Yes.
You got it listed. Okay. And how much are you guys asking?
$460.
Okay. Because you guys were at $486 before, correct?
Yeah. We thought probably a little too high for the neighborhood.
I got you. Okay. Well, listen, I will. My team and I will see what we can do to bring you a buyer, and we'll go from there.
That'd be great.
Thank you.
All right, Brandon.
Yep. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Again, another FSBO that's listed with an agent, and it wasn't me, probably, again, because I didn't fucking follow up enough. So I never lost a listing because I followed up too much, but I lose them from not following up. $450,000 listing, gone, lost it. And again, I don't think about it. I just keep rocking and rolling.
Hello.
Hey, Jeff, Brandon, how are you?
I'm good, Brandon. How are you doing?
Doing great. Did you and Donna, did you guys end up selling the property on Woody yet?
I've had a couple people looking at nothing yet, no.
Okay. I've been trying to get a hold of Donna. I know at one point you guys were open to interviewing agents. Have you gone down that path just yet, or?
We already got a guy, Brandon.
Cool. No worries.
I heard a guy a couple weeks ago.
Good for you. So he went ahead and listed the property on the market, correct?
Yep, we got
a little bit
now.
All right, very good. Well, wishing you guys best of luck.
Thanks, Brandon.
Hey, not a problem. Talk to you soon. See you, Jeff. Again, there's another example. I mean, you just got to stay in front of these people all the freaking time. They all end up listing. Yeah, so Michael, yeah, after they're listed, then I'm done. I'm probably done at that point. So I have one folder for each month. So when I talk to somebody and say, hey, we're looking to sell next year, I throw them in a folder. I have one folder for my hottest leads, my now listing appointments, and I've got my Monday folder, and that's it. Because they're all right in front of me. I can't fucking lose them, but today I've been losing a lot of these listings.
Hello.
Hi, Sandy. It's Brandon. How are you?
Good. How are you?
I'm doing well. Just wanted to follow up with you and Greg. How's the sale moving along with your property there? Did you guys get it sold?
Yes, we did.
Oh, congratulations.
Yeah, thanks. Yeah. We're just waiting for, it's FHA, so they got to do an inspection, so we're just kind of waiting on that. But he already had one inspector in and it passed, but we're waiting. I think the mortgage company is requiring a water test and on the septic.
Yeah, exactly. No, that makes a lot of sense. If something pops up, Sandy, and you need any assistance, let me know on that. But my other question is, are you guys still thinking about selling the rest of your rentals this year or next?
Yeah, we are working on, we have our Flint Ridge property up for sale. We haven't posted it or listed it yet, but we do have an offer on it already.
Awesome. No, that's great.
Yeah. Yes.
How do I get you and Greg out for a nice steak dinner so we can finally meet?
Well, I do want to meet you, that's for sure. And he has conceded that our other lady is definitely out.
Okay.
And I kind of told him I thought that, you know, with your persistence, that should we need a realtor, we definitely will hire you.
Awesome. No, I appreciate that, Sandy.
Yep.
And so
yep.
I'll stay in touch and let me know when you guys want to grab a cup of coffee, seriously. And just me. We don't need to commit to doing anything right now. But I would love to walk you guys through our flexible commission program and all of those things that we've talked about in the past. So
that sounds good. The other two properties are gone, but we do have, as a matter of fact, I'm at my Sherry Drive house right now.
Okay.
My tenant just moved out and we're looking at what we need to do over here to get it on the market. And it's going to need a lot of work.
Okay.
But we thought about remodeling it. And really ripping down some walls and really making the kitchen bigger and whatnot. My husband's now telling me we're going to leave it as is and just have it recarpeted and painted.
Yeah,
he's putting all that money into it. We're not sure we can get the money out in this neighborhood, you know?
That's exactly right. Where's that one at on Sherry Drive?
It's 818 Sherry. It was my mother-in-law's house.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so we got it in 2012.
Okay.
And we've had it rented since the 2012 when we got the house. And we decided now this is one that's going to go. It's cool. Got a well also, so we're trying to just kind of get rid of the wells.
I don't blame you.
What do you know? What do they look for when they inspect a well in septic? Do you know?
Yeah, I mean they're just, well, the septic, they're just making sure there's no cracks in the septic tanks, right? And so, and then the well, it's mostly about the water, but making sure there's no damage to the well. But every time you do an FHA, they're gonna test that water for sure, 100% of the time.
Yeah, okay.
So obviously cash and conventional makes it easier when you're dealing with well and septic, but it is what it is.
Yeah. The other is conventional, but this one is FHA. So
got it.
We'll see what happens with this. I don't know. The well's okay. You know, the water pressure's not that great in that house, though, so I don't know what
okay.
to come up with. We'll see.
Yeah, we'll see. Well, if you're around this week, I don't mind stopping by, look at Sherry to see what you have there. I'll give you some recommendations as well. Are you around in the afternoon Thursday?
Yeah, you know what? I would like to meet you. We would like to meet you, even though we're not ready to list with you yet. But
sure.
Yeah, we'd at least like to, you know, get a look at us and us get a look at your face.
That'd be great.
Yeah, and then take it from there. So probably better. Well, you know what? We are kind of pressed this week only because we're leaving out of town on Sunday. We'll be gone until the 7th.
Oh, okay.
So it might be better, and we're not going to do anything in this house until that time probably. So it might be better for us just to shoot for that following week when we get back so that we can meet you. And you can look at our sharing property and just give us some ideas of what you think if you're willing to do that.
No problem.
And then, you know, if something comes up and we want to hire an agent, we'll definitely shoot anything your way.
No, that sounds good. We'll just, I'll plan on following up the week of the 8th, which is just next week, essentially. And
right.
then we can.
Well, it would be the following week because we're going to be gone the week of the 8th.
Oh, got it. You come back the following week, the week of the 15th.
Yeah. Right.
Got it. Okay. Yeah, I have no problem coming over to check out the house. And I think what you said is exactly right. We'll have a chance to meet, make some recommendations,
right.
and then we'll just go from there.
Thank you, Brandon.
Of course.
Thanks for calling.
You got to have a great trip, Sandy.
Thank you.
Okay. Bye-bye. So that's what I built my career on, which was the call you just heard, is how I built my career. That's right, Matt. Persistence. I mean, you just heard her. Thank you for being so persistent. If we're going to hire an agent, we're going to hire you. I've not met with her. I've not had a face-to-face with her yet. Zero. And so that doesn't change anything for me. I just keep following up. So I'm going to just put her on my calendar to follow up with her. And that's a great listing opportunity. So make sure you're following up with all your FSBOs forever. That's what I teach all of you to do. If you stop calling, there's people like me calling, and we get the listing. Follow up with Sandy. I'm going to put on my counter, get listing. So, again, gives you guys an insight of how these calls go. Hopefully you guys are doing some of this stuff. So Jason, I like it. Just have to work on my follow-up system. I really want a very simple tracking system so I know when to follow up with who. Dude, I'm telling you, I took everything, Jason and gang. My conversion went through the fucking roof when I got out of my CRM and oversimplified everything. And go to fucking Home Depot, get some manila folders, and put people in there. I mean, it's pretty, I don't know how much simpler it is than that. I call FSBOs in the morning. You guys saw me do that this morning. I got 5 leads right here. These leads, I got 1 appointment. The other 5 are going in this same folder. And then they all get a call next Monday. And I just do that forever until they become a hotter lead. Then they go in my daily folder. It's like, couldn't be more simple than that. These CRMs make it so much more complicated. It doesn't have to be that hard. All right, so that's it for now. I'll be back with you guys later. Get on the phone, start setting appointments. Let's go. Let's have a huge, huge week.